Picture a car going backwards in your head. Even if there is no oncoming vehicle, it feels dangerous. Departure and landing from the runway are both from one direction, but did you know that taxiing in the opposite direction of the aircraft can sometimes happen on runways? It is not easy to imagine an aircraft moving in the opposite direction on a runway. So, is it the fault of a drunken pilot and controller? It is absolutely not. This happens either because the controller instructs it or at the request of the pilot. This is called a back taxi or backtrack. Shall we find out more about what this means now? The FAA defines back taxi as follows. On the other hand, ICAO uses backtrack instead of back taxi in the same situation. Although the expression differs depending on the organization, both are used as terms to describe the taxiing in opposite direction of an aircraft. So when will this happen? For convenience, we will continue to refer to it as a back taxi. First, this often occurs at small airports where there are only one or two taxiways from the runway to the apron due to the airport structure. In the case of the structure, as shown in this picture, after landing on runway 27, the pilot must taxi in the reverse direction through the runway to enter the apron. Same for takeoff. It is an essential choice for small airports that lack intersection taxiways. Second, when there is not much traffic. If the route from the apron to the runway is an airport with a complicated structure, approval is granted when there is a request from the pilot under the situation where there are no other aircraft to take off or land immediately, or when the controller determines that the back taxi is suitable due to traffic flow. Third, there is a problem with the taxiway and the runway must be used as a taxiway. For example, suppose that some part of a taxiway was found to be broken and it takes several hours to recover. Should aircraft that take off later have to wait until recovery? As another example, let's say that a taxiing aircraft had a problem while taxiing and stopped on the taxiway. Should the aircraft waiting in the back just wait until the problem with the aircraft is resolved and taxi is possible, or until the towing car tows the aircraft and clears the taxiway? In this case, we apply a back taxi. Finally, we have this case. This is the case where heavy aircraft land at an airport where there are few heavy aircraft operations. When comparing the wingspan of an aircraft and the width of the taxiway, what should be done if the safety of the aircraft's wing cannot be guaranteed when using the taxiway? In this case, there is no choice but to instruct the aircraft to back taxi. Many of you may have heard of the Tenerife accident in 1977. Both aircraft conducted a back taxi on the same runway. One aircraft was scheduled to hold for departure after a 180-degree turn at the end of the runway, and the other aircraft was scheduled to back taxi while exiting through the intersection taxiway and hold. However, the aircraft that arrived on the runway before the taxiing aircraft left the runway took off, and the two collided on the runway. Because taxiing in the opposite direction always means taking a big risk, both the pilot and the controller should pay special attention to the back taxi. First of all, from the controller's point of view, when applying a back taxi, the separation interval from other aircraft should be considered more generously than usual. Because the time required for a 180-degree turn on a runway can vary by aircraft and runway, it is difficult to predict accurately. Failure to consider sufficient separation may cause a go-around of the landing aircraft. Special care should also be taken when two or more aircraft are taxiing together on a runway. In this case, the controller should notify both aircraft of each other's existence, confirm the exact location and intention of both aircraft, and issue a takeoff clearance or landing clearance. When hold instructions are required, standard phraseology should be used to remove any confusion. If the pilot is instructed to do a 180-degree turn on the runway, he must pay attention to runway conditions. It sounds obvious, but pilots should keep in mind that they can slide at the turning point, especially if it's snowing or raining. Many causes lead to accidents, such as runway excursion or slipping under these circumstances. For this reason, a turn pad can be seen at the end of the runway at airports where backtaxiing is frequent. In addition, the pilot who received the backtaxi command must know exactly where to enter the runway and where to exit the runway, and must check with a controller in case of uncertainty. It is especially dangerous in climates where the runway is not visible to the controller and the pilot. When entering the runway, vacating the runway, and whenever necessary, the pilot reports his position, which the controller must reconfirm. Here's what we've prepared this time. Whether due to traffic conditions or structural problems with runways and taxiways, caution is not enough in situations where a backtaxi is required. In other words, you have to check and check, and doubt again. Do not forget. So have a safe day. ATC for you.